After being slammed by angry and frustrated residents over his response to the flood crisis, the Prime Minister, Scott Morrison, is now trying to blame the states. He was in Brisbane today to make a big announcement about defence, but spent more time defending himself. Political editor Peter Van Onselen has the story.
He didn't hold a hose during the bushfires.
Look at this broom.
But brooms are a different matter.
Getting a lot of work out.
He's had problems with handshakes in the past.
You take care.
But freshly out of COVID ISO, Scott Morrison wasn't afraid to shake as many hands as he could. The PM continued inspecting the flood-ravaged east coast today in Brisbane, first with a message of unity.
We work with all governments around the country.
Before returning to the old-fashioned blame game.
But the primary responsibility for these issues rests with the Queensland Government. We have offered billions and billions for dams here in Queensland, and we would love to get on and build those dams. Flood mitigation works in Australia are primarily a state responsibility.
When he wasn't hanging blame on the floods on state Labor, the PM fronted the media to announce
the biggest increase in the size of our defence forces in peacetime in Australian history.
18,500 new Defence Force personnel at a cost of $38 billion, increasing the size of the Defence Force by 30% by 2040.
The capability that we will achieve over the course of the next decade is significant, it's internationally recognised, and it's absolutely necessary.
No doubt this is driven by an election timetable rather than a full analysis of our overall force posture.
We're putting the boots on the ground, we're putting the planes in the air, and we're putting the ships out to sea.
And there were these not-so-subtle digs at Labor.
If you can't protect your borders and if you can't stare down people smugglers, how on earth can you pretend that you're the same as this government?
If we had kept Defence Force spending at the same rate as what the Labor Party left us, there would be $55 billion less spent in our Defence Forces today.
Leaving more money for aged care, childcare, schools, and even flood mitigation. Khaki election, here we come. Peter Van Onselen for 10 News First.